My boyfriend is wearing a fucking suit to his autism diagnosis appointment.
It's a special event.
Shut up.
You like someone.
Well, that's, I mean, I could not, I really don't.
Called it. Sasha owes me a fiver. So, who is it?
I don't have to tell you anything.
Is it Rosie? I know you've been talking about her a lot lately.
Is this an interrogation now?
So it is Rosie.
No, it's not Rosie.
Oh,
Tim, listen.
All right, we're getting somewhere. Oh, it's not David, is it?
What?
Oh, Martin, you can do better. I mean, did you see what he was wearing?
It's not David, and I don't want to do this, okay? Now, if you could just please let me get back
Hannah's
to...
Hannah's married. But that doesn't necessarily mean that it's not her.
No.
Wait. Are you being so dodgy about this because it's one of us? Is it Sasha? Is it?
Tim, I'm literally begging you.
All right, fine. Have it your way. Keep your precious secrets.
There's an archivist loose in the archives. It's never happened before. No one knows what the archivist is going to do next. Least of all the archivist. He's never been in an archive before. He's as confused as you are.
I went back over to the Calliope.
I thought it was pronounced Calliope.
Sasha, you're back early. I thought you were trying to get hold of those police reports for the Harold Silvana case.
Tried and succeeded. They were actually quite helpful.
Oh. Well, good work.
So, do we know if it's pronounced Calliope or Calliope?
I have also heard it said as Calliope.
Seriously? By who?
Americans.
Ah.
As far as I can tell, there isn't a correct pronunciation, but they were originally named after the Greek muse Calliope, so...
Are people going to understand that it's from Greek mythology?
If they are working for the Magnus Institute, then I would hope so.
I've just heard it more often as Calliope.
Good evening, Detective.
Oh!
Useless, scheming piece of shit.
Detective, this is quite unnecessary.
I'm sorry. Was that unnecessary?
Oh!
Because this is the most helpful you've been so far. Unless you've got another crisis for me.
No. It's fine. I'm sorry.
Oh yeah? For which part?
All of it.
You sent us to the North fucking Pole for no goddamn reason.
A miscalculation.
No, I'm done with your games.
Basira.
And when exactly were you planning to tell us he's been feeding on innocence?
I've always thought that a man's eating habits were his own private business. But I can't see how maybe I should have mentioned it.
Imagine having beef with me. I'm just a funny jokester, a silly little guy. You're gonna have beef with a silly little guy? For shame.
The narrator is obnoxious and unfunny, with his humor and dialogue proving to be more irritating than entertaining. Unfunny!
All right.
They said we never make it, my sweet joy. Always remember.
Oh, what's the name of that helper of yours?
Martin.
No, the hot one. He has scars like you, but kind of manages to pull them off.
Yes, Tim.
Yeah, what's his deal? He gave me the weirdest grin when I came in just now, and like, a thumbs up.
I wouldn't worry about it.
No?
He thinks we're sort of... together?
No. You know I'm
no,
not.
No, I know. I mean, either I... He just got it in his head.
I mean, you're nice and all.
Yes,
and...
yes, no, I feel the same way.
Right. I mean, I suppose it's better he think that.
I won't tell if you won't.
Right. I'm gonna go, then.
Yes.
Max Contract's got some mighty fine print.
Some mighty fine print?
And that mighty fine print puts Mag in a mighty fine predicament. If Mag up and splits, her eyes are forfeit. And if Gene Co and Roddy so will it, then a repo man will come and she'll pay for that surgery. Surgery.
Hi, guys.
Tim.
Tim?
What the hell? I thought... How did you...
You made it!
Funny story, really. I ran into the office. Worms everywhere, horrible death and everything. Tripped and fell into some boxes. And there were like 20 cans of gas in there.
Are you alright? You seem a bit...
Fine gas, bit lightheaded. Not a lot of ventilation in the tunnels. Come on.
Into the tunnels?
Yeah, actually, not that many worms in there anymore. I think they've mostly gone into the archive. Although the ones down here are faster for some reason. And quieter.
You're not bitten, are you?
No, I don't think so.
My name is Jonathan Sip.
Yes, I know what a meme is.
I still don't even know who you are.
I am Michael. I was not always Michael. I do not want to be Michael. Being Michael stole the only purpose I have ever known.
You were Gertrude's assistant, weren't you?
No.
But the tape, heard you.
You heard... Michael.
What the hell are you
talking
about?
Quiet, archivist.
You need to stop moping.
I what?
You need to stop swanning around, being all sad.
I'm not swanning around.
Ooh, I'm so alone and a monster.
I am alone. Martin
busy
is...
Busy doing paperwork. Not like he's dead. Besides, he's not the only other person here, you know. There's me... Melanie, Basira.
Traumatised, and paranoid because of me.
Get over yourself. You're always talking about choices. We all made ours. Now we're making a choice to get some drinks.
Back the fuck up. When did this become a whorehouse?
I still can't believe Gertrude was allowed to let this place get into such a state.
I just want to know why.
What do you mean, why? You saw her. She's like 100 years old and more cardigan than woman. She just started to lose it. Sad, but it happens.
You never talked to her, did you?
Well, I mean, I must have at some point.
You'd remember.
Why? What was she like?
Stone cold bitch.
Sasha!
And sharper than you. No way this is accidental.
Oh yeah, this is all a big geriatric conspiracy. Wait, seriously?
Mm-hmm.
It's a coffin. There's a name engraved on it. Whore! It's empty! And you're going...
Do you even know they're lying to you?
I'm sorry, I didn't... Can I help you? This place is off limits.
I disagree.
Who let you in here?
Let? I'm afraid that isn't how this works.
You're him.
Yes.
Michael.
That is a real name.
Are you here to kill me?
No.
Oh. Why are you here?
I am simply collecting what is mine, archivist. The one who enters my domain.
Miss Richardson? You own those hallways?
What a fascinating question. Does your hand... in any way own your stomach.